After February 20th, we mobilized all kinds of people. We got a geotech firm out there to do the investigation. We have 18 different boreholes where we have pushed telemetry equipment in there, and we are constantly monitoring to see if there's any additional movement. Since February 20th, we have not seen significant, really any type of movement of this slide. It'd be easy to say, since there hasn't been any movement, why don't we just put the road back where it was? But we do need to lock in the slope. I know it's been good for 4 months. There's no guarantee it will continue to be like that. The final geotech report did look at a number of options. One of the options was to go around the backside. That proved a little problematic. It would have been on the order of 2 or 3 million yards of excavation. Could also have resulted in a lot of rockfall potential. Another option was a total realignment, not really feasible. We're looking at this option as the most feasible because it'll stabilize the slope, and we also move the roadway away from the most recent slide upslope. The recommendation is to move the road over 60 foot, take the rock from the cut, and put it at the base of the hill to form a rock buttress. The rock buttress will be anchored into at least 10 foot of bedrock, so we're anchoring both the most recent slide and also anchoring the ancient landslide that is across this entire Echo Cliffs area. We realized we set the bar pretty high with how quickly we moved on N20. Our normal development process on a project like this would be 2 or 3 years. We are going to do our best to accelerate it. The design is not going to be what takes us a lot of time. It's going to be the environmental work and the right-of-way acquisition. The right-of-way is massive. Compared to our normal right-of-way on state highways, we usually have 100 or 200 foot. The toe of the slope will now be almost 1,000 foot down on the bottom, and this cut slope, we're gonna look at least 200 or 300 foot right-of-way. So the right-of-way footprint is a lot larger than what we have right now. That does affect how we look at it environmentally. We have to be concerned about raptors and their nesting periods, so we can't blast during their nesting periods. We have to look at archaeology, that's another environmental component, and we also have to look at water quality. These are things that come with NEPA that most people don't understand that we need to do that, but we do have to balance the environment with our transportation needs, and that's one of the challenges we will have on this project.
ADOT, keeping Arizona moving.